Hi friends, welcome to our channel. Today we are seeing about the topic of mRNA. mRNA, this topic is most useful for the life science students and the pharmacy students. First we see what is mRNA. First we see the introduction of mRNA. The mRNA is an abbreviated term of microRNA. The microRNA is a small single stranded non-coding RNA molecule. It's usually found in plant, animal and viruses. It contains 22 nucleotides. Their function is RNA silencing and post-transfer regulation of gene expression. The main function of microRNA is RNA silencing and post-transcriptional regulation of gene expression. MicroRNAs comprise a novel class of small non-coding endogenous RNA that regulate gene expression by directing their target mRNAs for degradation or translation repression. Their discovery added a new dimension to the understanding of complex gene regulatory networks in human and animal alike. The main role of microRNA is represent the translation process, then it improves the transcription process. This is the main function of microRNA, and then it regulates the gene expression. This is the introduction of microRNA. Next, we see the working of microRNA. How does it work? MicroRNA are short non-coding RNA. They regulate gene expression post-transcriptionally. They generally bind to the 3' untranslated region of their target mRNAs and repress protein production by destabilizing the mRNA and translational silencing. In second point, protein production may be repressed. This is the main thing for translation process. In translation process, the protein molecules are produced. In repress the protein production, it will inhibit the translation process. So we are using the term translation silencing. This is the working of mRNA. Next we see the function of mRNA. mRNA function as a guide by base pairing with the target mRNA to negatively regulate its expression. The level of complementary between the guide and mRNA target determines which silencing mechanism will be employed. Cleavage of target mRNAs with subsequent degradation or translation inhibition. This is the function of mRNA. The main thing is already told, the transcription process is inhibited. This is the main mechanism for mRNA, and then regulates its gene expression. Next we see the formation of mRNA. The process of mRNA formation. Now we see the diagrammatic representation. In this process of mRNA formation, at first mRNA genes are transcribed to primary mRNA by RNA polymerase II in the nucleus. Primary mRNAs are cleaved by the RNase III type endonuclease dorsa, producing precursor mRNA as the next. After that, being transported by exporting 5 from nucleus to cytoplasm, precursor mRNAs are produced by another RNase third type endonuclease dicer to generate a mRNA protein complex with 2 strands. One strand of complex will become a mature mRNA, and then the mature microRNA is bound to RNA mediated silencing complexes such that RISC, RNA mediated silencing complex means RISC. Immediately in RISC, the mature mRNA targets the 3' untranslated region of their target mRNAs to regulate translational inhibition or mRNA cleavage. The other one will be degraded. This is the formation of mRNA formation or microRNA formation. Next we see the detection of mRNA. How to detect mRNA? In traditional method for detection of mRNA include first one, northern blotting, second one, quantitative reverse transcription polymerase chain reaction, QRT-PCR, next generation sequence, then microarray based hybridization. These are the methods to detect mRNA. Next we see the importance of microRNA. MicroRNA represent small RNA molecule encoded in genome of plants and animals. This highly conserved 22 nucleotides long RNA sequence regulate the gene expression of by binding to 3' untranslated region of specific mRNAs. A growing body of evidence shows that microRNA are one of the key players in cell differentiation and growth, mobility and apoptosis. Differentiating mRNAs from other class of microRNAs that are present in cell, often particularly the distinction from endogenous small interfering RNAs such that siRNAs. The most significant distinction between mRNA and siRNA is whether they silence their own expression. The most significant thing is silence their own expression. Almost all siRNA silence the same locus from which they were derived. On other hand, most mRNA does not silence their own loci but other genes instead. MicroRNAs regulate diverse aspects of development and physiology, thus understanding its biological role in providing more and more important. These are the importance of mRNA. Next we see the role of microRNA in diseases. The microRNA involve the diseases such as cancer, kidney disease and heart disease, nervous system, obesity and hemostasis. First we see role of microRNA in cancer. MicroRNA have the potential to be used as tool or target for the treatment of different cancers. MicroRNA also have link with cancer and accordingly are sometimes referred to as oncomers. MicroRNA involved in link with cancer, so it named as oncomers. The expression level of mRNA 205 and 373 have been shown to be increased in mucinous colorectal cancer and mucin producing ulcerative colitis associated colon cancers, but not in sporadic colonic adenocarcinoma that lacks mucinous components. The mRNA 205 and 375 involved in the colorectal cancer. Next, in hepatocellular carcinoma, cell proliferation may arise from mRNA 21 interaction with MAP2K3, a tumor repressor gene. This is the mRNA 21 involved in hepatocellular carcinoma. In classical Hodgkin lymphoma, plasma mRNA 21, 494, 1973 are promising disease response biomarkers in Hodgkin's lymphoma. The specific microRNA 506 has been found to work as a tumor antagonist in several studies. A significant number of cervical cancer samples were found to have down-regulated expression of mRNA 506. Additionally, the 506 works to promote apoptosis of cervical cancer cells through its direct target Hedgehog pathway transcription factor. This is the main role of mRNA in cancer. It involved in colorectal cancer and hepatocellular carcinoma, Hodgkin's lymphoma and cervical cancers. Next we see microRNA in heart disease. The global role of microRNA function in the heart has been addressed by conditionally inhibiting microRNA maturation in the murine heart. This revealed that microRNAs play an essential role during its development. MicroRNA expression profiling studies demonstrate that expression level of specific microRNA change in diseased human hearts, pointing to their involvement in cardiomyopathies. It also involved in the regulation of key factors important for cardiogenesis, the hypertrophic growth response and cardiac conductance. MicroRNA in animal models have also been linked to cholesterol metabolism and regulation. These are things for major role in heart disease. Next, what are the role of microRNA in nervous system? MicroRNA appear to regulate the development and function of the nervous system. Neutral microRNA are involved at various stages of synaptic development, including dendritogenesis, synapse formation and synapse maturation. It involves microRNA 132, 134 and 124. Some studies find altered microRNA expression in Alzheimer's disease as well as schizophrenia, bipolar disorder, major depression and anxiety disorders. These are things in the major role of microRNA in nervous system. Next we see the role of microRNA in hemostasis. MicroRNAs also play crucial role in the regulation of complex enzymatic cascades including the hemostatic blood coagulation system. Large-scale studies of functional microRNA targeting have recently uncovered rational therapeutic target in hemostatic systems. Next we see the microRNA delivery system. Most of the microRNAs are encapsulated in the form of nanoparticles. The nanoparticles encapsulate the microRNA, thus shielding charge group and allowing their uptake by cells. Functionalizing nanoparticles with cell-specific ligand allows nanoparticle to deliver microRNA to specific cells, thus reducing off-target effects. Nanoparticles allows for controlled microRNA release and avoiding excessive activation of multiple gene targets. Next, we see the what are the delivery systems in microRNA. In the size 379, 159, 7A, 146, 145, 185, these are involved in the extracellular vesicles, and 34A, 133, 660, 634 that are involved in liquid nanoparticle, and microRNA 16 involved in bacterial min cells, microRNA 100 involved in gold nanoparticles, microRNA 122 involved in dendrimers, microRNA 204 involved in silica nanoparticles. These are the drug delivery systems of microRNA. Today we see about the introduction of microRNA and working and its function and what are the formation process of microRNA and the detection techniques, importance of microRNA and the role of many diseases such as the cancer, heart disease, kidney, nervous system, obesity and hemostasis. Then finally we discuss the delivery systems. Thank you.